Good afternoon and thank you. The moderators and panels are designers whose work I admire and learn from, plus their great friends, Amir, Shantanu. Okay, Vivek is giving me instructions and I'm very obedient in case anyone ever forgets that. Thank you, Vivek, especially you. So essentially, our design practice is inherently at its core collaborative, and my presentation is based on this entire concept. I think it takes a village to build a project, and no man or woman is an island. The very word collaboration, of course, I'm a little bit of a nerd and I love language, so you can see it's derived from Latin, which I don't need to bore you with. I'm going to illustrate this point through a couple of projects that I will share. So the first project is the one I call my soulmate. So there are many kind of collaborations that we enter into in every project. Like Amit was saying, it's a designer and a vendor, or a designer and co-collaborators. But at the heart and at the start of it all, it's the client. For me, that's my primary collaborator. It's not that I dream, rather it is that we dream together. And our clients put their faith, their money, their dreams, all of it in our hands. This project that I'm sharing is literally where the client and I were soulmates. So this is a bespoke chairman, managing director office for a pharmaceutical company. And that is as intimate and personal as a home, despite being an office space. Again, I go back to the level of synergy between the client and me. It was off the charts. Should you ever want to fill your home and your spaces with art, you're my soulmate. Everybody here, do call me. And you will see plenty of that here. This was one of the reasons why it became so personal. But I also want to bring in here the second level of collaboration that happens in every project that any of us work on. And that is the contracting teams who execute our designs. So this, for example, is a flooring that we designed, which is bespoke and derived from the logo of the client's company. So first collaborator, the logo and the client. Second, the team that executed it. Garnet was the contracting team. Nitco actually made this gorgeous floor for us. I think it's really important to give credit where due, and that's why I want to talk about our collaborations across board. I dream, we draw, they build, right? That's how it goes. This is an example of what a great collaboration with the right executing team, the unsung collaborators, is all about. We worked with Loco Design, who are a bespoke furniture design company, to create this conference room, this large boardroom table. It's actually a 28-seater table, which is massive, beautifully executed, all custom details that we worked on. They specialize in leather work. Again, we brought the logo of the company into play because we wanted to make the space intimate and personal, which is part of our design intent. But Loco Designs was the one that took it to another level. The combination of leather, metal, and wood, beautifully executed by them. Garnet finishing the entire space, and then the carpet. So, pharma company thriving on R&D. We wanted to bring that into play as well. And we had this custom carpet woven. A shout out to everyone who manufactures, the craftsmen who make it, and who make our spaces look so good. These two spaces actually illustrate multiple collaborations. A very important part, the lighting designers who bring our spaces to life. This was done by the fabulous team at Visavi, and that balance of light that is so crucial to all our designs can be seen here. Tucked away in the corner on the image on the left, if you can see, is another beauty that's foregrounded, though it's in the corner thanks to the lighting. It's a custom ceramic installation that we worked on with a ceramist. And Loco Designs again worked with us to create the shelving unit on the right, which is actually a shutter. These details we couldn't have made on our own. Like I said, we dream, we draw, and then somebody else brings it to life. This is one of my favorite spaces. It shows a stunning Rushad Shroff designed flower table, a bespoke light in sunshine yellow, and that delicately detailed design concealed storage that you see on the wall behind, that Garnet worked on for us. Every single detail, for example, I'm sorry, the image is sort of pixelating on the screen, but these are tiny little capsules that hide the locking device and is a little nod to the fact that it's a pharma company. So when we visualized the space, we were very fortunate. We had these long, beautiful corridors that we used to our advantage in this project. Our intent from the start was to create a custom installation for this long wall. The image on the left shows how it looked without the installation. And then came the magical Clove team of Gautam and Pratik, who worked with us to create this installation, derived from the fathers of pharmacy, the apothecaries. So this is an old apothecary version that they created for us. Again, you can see the difference. There is so much richness that they brought to our spaces. The second project that I want to share is called All About Mutual Trust. I think faith lays the firmest foundations, and this project is a great illustration of that. This is a home that I call an ode to all my Bombay friends here. That's because in terms of scale, it's a compact 1500 square feet that holds two bedrooms, walk-ins, bathrooms, a living dining, and an alfresco area that opens up. Delhi, Vivek is sitting right here, will tell you 1500 is not the same scale. But what happened here was that the intent always is to design spaces that have joy, a sense of warmth, welcome and comfort. This influences everything about the design, from the macro aspects like the space volumes that you see in the image on the left and the cozy window seat that you see on the right. Again, ode to the contractor, ode to many people whose work you see here. My work is incomplete without the furniture designers, without all these little details. Design is layered for me. The journey, of course, begins with volume and light, but the end result is replete with micro details, the textures, the touch feel, the tone, the tint. I'm not really about the big statements or the bells and whistles, but more about the million details that come together to form a balanced whole. Enter the creative design genius of Demuro Das, who make the most beautiful furniture. The tender beauty in the center of Harshita Jhamtani's lamps. I know the Muse boys know it. We are all big fans. The raw beauty of the Naga table that you see on the left, which is from Sarita Handa. And then I had a blast designing this one piece that Shantanu was smiling and telling me about, which is a piece that I designed with Orvi, where I learned so much about this kind of work and where you can take it. Imagine how empty these spaces would have been without all of these things coming together and making this a fulfilled home. So this is a movie which will hopefully play about the home that we designed, and I will stop talking.
Was just a word they sang about in songs I heard. It took your kisses to reveal that I was wrong and love is real. Hold me close and hold me fast. This magic spell you cast, this is l'aviance. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see l'aviance. Press me to your heart. I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Everyday words seem to soul to me, and life will always be la vie en rose.
This means so much to me because it's all of you whose work I love, admire, who I love and admire. An ode to Shobhan Kothari, who's not here, because I've never made a film, and he has said to me in rather rude words that I shouldn't repeat here, that I was a fool, that's the polite version, and I need to start making films, which is why I made my first film. So, thank you, Shobhan. And that's what I mean by collaboration, because I think we are enriched and blessed to have the fraternity and the friends we do. And then this was the last thing I'm going to talk about, because we work with the genius of furniture designers and millwork specialists and craft companies and bespoke fabric and linen studios. Like, I know what the Muse boys have done with that amazing staircase with Rushad and his flower presses. We've talked about that. But all of these things in art galleries, of course, I'll say it for Ekta and for me, they come together to create that umami bomb for any project that we work on. During the COVID lockdown, I was really fortunate to get an opportunity to do something completely new that I had never done. I was asked to be the art director of a new furniture brand called Sunday. This is Sunday. Something that I had never done. This was a new, exciting style of collaboration. I worked very closely with Shannon Sadler, a super talented furniture designer from Milan, to create 5 different collections. And it was such a learning experience for the eternal student in me, because A, I was working with somebody from another country who has a different process, a different system. There were technical nuances that I learned that I was not aware of. Different joinery details, appropriate hardware that we had to find because it's not, you know, what you'll get in Italy is not necessarily available here. And I'm sure Rajiv will relate to this and so much more. But the furniture is manufactured in India, and that was a second collaborative exercise, because you had to work between the designer, translating that into the art direction, choosing materials, and then working with the manufacturer. The third, now this is the last bit that I have to talk about. I learned from the work of my design heroes and my colleagues and friends, and this is what I mean by collaborative. I discuss and I ideate with some close friends from the fraternity who are here. And I always walk away feeling enriched with new ideas, a different perspective of looking at things. This is a project that we are working on, very fortunately, with the legendary Abhimanyu Dalal. He's the architect. And we are translating that space on the left into this. He's taught us so much, you know, he's enriched our basic SOPs in a totally different way. And so I think collaboration is all about an exploration of how to push our boundaries, ideas, designs, and details. Last but not the least, I'm just going to end my presentation, but I'm going to say something. I'm going to say something that I think I speak for all of us. Our studios, I think they are the spine, the core of our being. I'm very envious of the 8 to 5 a.m. Muse boys. very, very envious. That's where we dream, we have our mad ideas, sometimes we yell, shout, scream. The MEP consultants who make all our spaces functional. The lighting consultants who say, like, God, let there be light. The landscape designers and so many more. But at the end, enough cannot be said about the workers at every one of all our sites. They are the ones who collaborate in the richest sense on all our projects, to those who get plastered plum walls, to the stonemasons who lay the stones in those perfect invisible joints, carpenters, polishers, painters, electricians, plumbers, and many, many more. We cannot exist without them. They are our biggest, biggest collaborators in that sense. Lastly, to the uber-talented photographers who make our work look so good and who bring our work to life, a big, big thank you to all of you, and may long live collaboration. Thank you.